Hello everyone, this is another vlog thing with my dog thing. I don't know if you can see him, but he's right here and he's been really annoying today. He just keeps whining for no reason. I think it's just because he sees people outside. He's just a big baby. He's like, oh my god, I want to meet them. He's really friendly, so he's just like, yeah. Exciting news. I thought it was a duck at first. My mistake, I don't like wearing my glasses or contacts, and so I thought it was a duck. But we're actually getting a little baby bird, like a little sparrow or a robin or a thing. Because my fiance works at an amusement park that has a zoo in it, and they found this bird by a ride today, and it's a little baby, so it like can't really fly or do anything for itself yet. No idea where the parents are. There's endless trees, so it could honestly be anywhere. And so they handed it over to the zoo portion of the park, and they're taking care of it right now. And so they might just send it home with us, because why not? And so I was gonna tell you guys a funny story, but I can't remember which one it was. I actually remember this time. I remember because it involves this one. So, living in an apartment, we don't have a doggy door, obviously. We do have one of those little potty pads on our balcony, but of course someone doesn't like to use them, do you? No, because you're a brat. We've had it for about a month. He doesn't use it at all. There goes $50. We're trying to get him to use it still, but in the meantime, we just take him down to the dog park for the majority of the stuff, because he gets exercise and stuff, so it's good for him, right? So we're at the dog park, and it's literally like 11 at night, because we had just gotten home from doing something. We let him out of his kennel. We used to let him walk around, but he kept peeing and pooping in the house, and so that stopped. So now he gets to sit in the kennel, because he just doesn't like behaving. So anyways, at the dog park, running laps, because you know what, he's got a lot of energy, I'm tired, I don't want to have to deal with him late at night. So running laps, right? I used to run. That's also where I'm wearing this, because I'm going to tell you another story that involves running. Basically, I'm just this uncoordinated mess. And so I'm running around the dog park, and there's this little part in the center. It's pretty close to the center where a lot of the bigger dogs have, like, dug. And so there's some parts that go that, like, are holes, some parts that are, like, hills, because that's where the dirt ended up after they dug. And so, yeah, the entire thing is grass, except for this little thing in the middle that's like half grass, half dirt, because dogs keep digging it. And so I'm running around. And rather than running laps, I just like, well, let's just run back and forth. Let's run back and forth, because all the dogs poop on the outskirts. So I'm like, I'm not doing that at night. I can't see where the poop is. And there's like no light. There's no light. There's two lamps on either side, but they don't work. Yeah. So, running laps. And I'm running back, and I've got this nice bruise on my knee now, because I'm running back, and I knew where the dirt mound was, and so I step, but I don't step high enough, and so my foot clips the side of a dirt mound, and I just face plant right into the ground. Yeah, it did not feel good at all. And I just kind of lay there for a minute. And I still had a hold of the dog's leash, because I was running with him on the leash, because I tried running with him without the leash, and he just kept getting distracted, and he kept trying to pee, even though he had literally no pee left. So, running back and forth, trip, laying there on the ground, I kind of just like roll over, I just look at the sky like, and then my dog just comes and licks my face. So I just lay there for a minute, my dog licking my face. And I hobble up the stairs, and there's this part that I typically carry my dog, because there's just glass and stuff everywhere, and there's like this little grate, like it's grated steps. That's the only way I can describe it. Like there's little, it's metal stairs with like, they're like half an inch by 2 inches long, probably little holes, and they hurt his feet because it's all metal. It's hard to explain. Maybe I'll just show you guys at some point. So I hobble up the stairs, I hobble in the house, and I just kind of lay on the floor. And my fiance comes in, she's like, what's wrong? And I'm like, I don't want to talk about it. And so, yeah. The many uncoordinated adventures of Moon. Can't talk English, and I cannot run. Which is ironic, because I, being very uncoordinated, the only sport I took to was running. And let me tell you, it was not fun. Like, somehow we enjoyed it, but that doesn't mean it was fun. It does not mean it was fun. It was torturous. Some people are like, oh yeah, soccer players can run up to 9 miles in one game. I've run up to 9 miles in one sitting. I've run 18 miles in one day. Yeah. That's not really a whole lot. Sorry, soccer players. I used to be really good. I'm pretty sure I've already told you guys this in the first episode. I was really good at running. It was really funny because there was this one race, and it was in this place called Park City, which, for those of you who don't live where I live, it's this really tall mountain, and it's this really random high school field tucked away within said mountain. And they decided, you know what, let's have a race here. And so it's like literally probably 30 degrees Fahrenheit. It was absurd. And we have to wear short shorts and tank tops. And some of the guys wore like little stretchy pants underneath that they call spandex. But those people also technically would have gotten disqualified if they like had placed, because it's not team jersey. But if they're one of the slower guys, they usually just don't care. But so I'm sitting here in my little short shorts and this tank top. It was just awful. It was just so cold until we started running. The best part was that there were so many people, and so like if you ran in a little pack, you're like, oh. Just like take turns in the middle. Yeah, it was not fun. And so anyways, during this entire race, I later found out that I had gotten into like fifth place on my team, because the top seven are considered varsity, but the top five only like count for your team. That's, if you really want to look it up, you can look it up. It's a lot of math and dumb and stuff. For the scoring in running makes little to no sense. But anyways, so the top five score, I found out later that I was literally the fifth man. And so I'm like, I'm not complaining. And this was like my first time racing this course. So this was my first season of cross country. It's a 3 mile race. For everyone else, that's a 5K, 3.1 miles technically. And so I'm going, I'm just hauling. And I didn't really process it, but I was like, I was basically just the seventh man for most of the season. And so I passed this guy, who I totally forget is typically our sixth man, because if you're the third man, you don't have to place third. If you do better, you can place second. If you do worse, the person fourth can pass you. It's that easy. Like, if, I don't know, I don't really know any other sports to compare it to. Never mind. I don't know any other sports, really. And so, I'm just sitting here, I'm running. And I've got like this, like, weird face, just like, I'm breathing that hard too, because like, the last 100 meters of the race is called the kick. That's where, if you're so exhausted that you can't move a muscle, your natural instinct is to run faster. And so I have been known at the end of some races to just yell, just let out this blood-curdling scream, just because I have no adrenaline left. And so I kind of just scream and start sprinting as fast as I can. The first time I did it, it was because I thought I pulled a muscle. It only happened a few times after that, just because it just happens sometimes. My coaches thought it was hilarious. I don't know why I did it. It was just a thing. And so rather than yelling this time. I'm just senior running. Also, I spot my teammate because we had, like, our mascot was the Mustang, so I spot Mustangs down his back, and our jerseys were also white. So, no, it wasn't this exact jersey. I have, like, literally 7 jerseys. And so I spot the white jersey because who puts a bunch of kids running through mud and snow and everything in a white jersey? I don't know. So I spot him. And I'm like, I'm just sitting here running. Remember my face and the heavy breathing. And I pass him. And this is literally like the start of the 100 meters, like the last 100 meters. And I just turn to him and I scream, "Vibrate!" And like, I don't remember making the face, but like apparently when I was looking at him, I just made this face of like, that like literally scared the crap out of him. Like I'm just like he said, my neck was all tense and my face was drawn back and my eyes were like wide, and he said that they might have been bloodshot, but he couldn't tell. I just turn to him and I scream, "Fire me!" And I just take off sprinting. And I'm like, why did I yell, "Fight me?" And like I know why, like I wanted him like to fight me to the finish line, like to push, so we could push each other, right? And so I just take off sprinting, and I became well known for never being beaten in my kick, except for 2 or 3 times in the span of 4 years, with at least 100 races, probably. That's my best guess. Only 2 or 3 times was I ever beaten. Just because I don't know what it is, it just, once I saw the finish line, everything just shut off and I felt no pain. I wish that could happen the whole race, because running hurts. If you never run, don't. It hurts. Anyhow, so we're sprinting and I pass the finish line like split second before he does. And apparently, I can't remember what he got, but he had actually injured himself, and that's why he was slowing down near the end of the race. And so when I turned and screamed, "Fight me," it gave him that little extra oomph to finish. And so he comes sprinting in right behind me, and I ended up having to carry him out. And we had to go to the hospital later, but it was great. It was great. In other news, Trigger Joe has passed. I don't know if it was because of too little light or if it was just not enough water, but I come in one day and he is just shriveled up, and so I threw him away because he was rotting. I was pissed. It literally happened overnight. Currently have 2 plants on the balcony, and Pierre has been reunited with Edna, the bamboo, and I think that's it. Until next time, everyone, happy gaming. Hey guys, if you really enjoyed this video, or if you think I'm just this ugly mug who deserves a poor like for his soul, drop a like down below, maybe even subscribe, check out our games. We have our website, which is www.sidali.net, I think. Don't quote me on that, because I've basically just been making videos for the past few weeks because I haven't been very active in the community other than that. Go check out Megan's channel. She has like Black Desert Online, Sims 4. It's pretty cool, guys. Like, she just got the new expansion pack for Sims, which is Dine Out, so go check that out. I know that she's making some new stuff for Black Desert. Go check it out, guys. It's pretty awesome. And according to Bax Tabber, B-A-X space Tabber, from the last video, he has stated that whoever dislikes the video, you're going to be fed to me, apparently. I just ate, so I think you guys are safe for another week at least, because, like, I don't know, I'm a little bit full. But, no, I'm just kidding. I don't know, just let me know what you guys thought. If you guys think my stories are funny, that's great. If not, I'm funny. That's what my mom says, at least, so, yeah. Alright. Have a great day, guys.